Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brereus Kerensky, and welcome to the first hour play of Vasara Collection. Since there are three games... made in Unity. Really? They ported the whole games in Unity? Or maybe just the renewed part? Well, let's see. Anyway, so, since there are three games, 20 minutes apiece should be enough to get a good idea on how this shooting collection is. So, first impressions aren't particularly good. Mostly because it's kind of low resolution with no anti-aliasing and the frame rate wasn't particularly great. Can I remap the controls? Apparently not, which I hope is good enough for a stick, an arcade stick. Vertical mode. Okay, so this is screen rotation. This is incredibly barebone. This is beyond barebone. So no, there are not two games, but three games. The more I delve into this collection, the more confused I am. Let's go with the first Vasara then. Okay, that's... I hope there are... And suddenly the music is incredibly... low, and from what I see, there are no options. Wow. Okay, the music is playing, but it's incredibly low. I boxed myself in.
Thank you.
Wow, that was stupid. Oh, totally didn't saw that coming. So yeah, I'm bursting through credits. Wow, I'm absolutely not paying attention, and apparently physically hitting the boss doesn't kill me. Quite the strange decision. So I must say that I'm not particularly impressed by the game, and yeah, the collection itself is devoid of options that I would say are mandatory for this kind of games. Although how Cave and M2 shoot triggers dealt with their ports on current consoles and X360 / PS3 in the previous generation. Wow. Thank you. Oh, it's not dead yet. I am dead, Dodo. So continuing doesn't reset those things I collected. I would. I'm interested to know if. Talking while trying to avoid to dodge bullets is not a particularly good thing. If Unity is also used to run the emulation software for these games, other than the main menu. I like my buttons in a different arrangement that this game provides. I must say that I'm not particularly liking this game. There are interesting ideas, but I can feel that the bullet patterns aren't as good as cave shooters. It wants to be a bullet hell, but it doesn't really have the finesse of being one. It's also strange to be bumped around the stage if you collide with enemies.
Mada shinenai.
Yeah, let's bomb our way through levels, who cares? So, also, yeah, I haven't seen options about increasing life count, bomb count. Thank you. Wow, some attacks should have a little bit more time to build up and to make you understand that they are gonna trigger. Okay, I was testing if I found out a safe spot. did I start from the beginning on the level instead of continuing from where I... from where I died? Is this because it's the last level? If so, I'll switch to... I'll try to switch to the game because I haven't seen... an option menu in... So yeah, you restart from the beginning. Is there a pause button? Oh yes. And now I can also finally find the options. Livestock, easy, normal, vibration, subtitles, screen filter, finally. Smooth and sharp, I think one is... Wow! Yeah, one is nearest neighborhood and the other is probably bilinear. No, I didn't want that. Let's go back to the main menu. No. Is there a way to summon that menu? Okay, it's minus. Let's see what the gallery is before jumping into Vasara 2. Yeah, some of the art was probably done by guys at Strictly Limited, because it surely isn't the same style as the original design. Wow, you can see the pixels even here. Okay, so this is the third game. Let's first go back and check Vasara 2. Vasara 2. I don't know why I have to P-power up, one up. Wow. So, by default... Okay, you can rotate the screen here. Just one wallpaper. the volume levels aren't the same between games. Okay, this feels oh so much better than the first one. I was trying to read the subtitles.
Thank you.
I'm still not particularly impressed by the game, but it plays much better than the first one. It feels more competently made, and controls are tighter. I also like more the color choices. Still, I've played better. Although it feels that you need to use bombs to defeat certain enemies in time,
あまり逆らうとは愚か者め黙ってゆけ。
So yeah, my strategy right now is to fire bombs and die, then fire all the bombs in the next life, abuse the infinite continue and go on with the game. Yeah, the thing that you bump into enemies is most probably something I will never get used to. Because it doesn't outright kill you, which is good, but in most cases it throws you right into another projectile, so there is no real need not to kill you on contact. And then I'll this will be my last continue on Vasara 2, and then I'll take a look at Vasara Timeless. Oh, Oda Nobunaga. So this is the final boss. Okay, maybe I'll spend a few more credits to see the game to completion. Okay, just like the other game, you start from the beginning. So, main menu. Let's go back to Vasara Timeless. Okay. Dash. And I'm playing with an arcade stick, not being able to remap buttons will prove difficult. Oh, this is full 3D. And you cannot remap controls here. Good. And I pressed main menu, sorry. So this is why this game is made in Unity, because this Vasara Timeless is new stuff. Because L is almost on the opposite side of where I have my main buttons. Oh, stages are random. Wow, this game is giving bombs like they are power-ups. And in fact, it's not giving power-ups. Instead, it's giving me... I already have 8 bombs! Okay, I must say that from this first stage... This is the worst of the collection. Yeah, another bomb. No! Oh, come on. That was stupid. Sorry, that was completely my fault. Let's try someone else. So I started with the same stage I started before. So maybe stage progression is not random, or maybe it's based on the characters you select. Yeah, that was completely my fault. With all this screen space to move around, slow characters are terrible to use. I can already feel that moving the ship around between a character with speed as 3 stars and 2 stars as it is now is a huge difference and not in a good way. It was already difficult to kill all enemies with fast characters, but with this kind of character is even harder. Yeah, okay, that's not particularly good to see, huh? Okay, so it's 1 credit and then you're dead. Oh, online leaderboards. Not particularly impressed with this timeless Vasara. To be honest, I'm not particularly impressed with this collection either. The fact that options are relegated to each and every game and there are no ways to remap the controls first and foremost. I don't know, it's not particularly great. Let's say ranking tutorial. Let's see where I... if I even... So, the rankings are just the first 10. Okay. So, yeah, not really impressed by this collection in terms of the games inside and the collection itself. But, let's see if extras hold something else. Gallery, tutorial, credits. Let's see what the tutorial... Oh, it's just that. Okay, nothing much else to do in the extras. But, well, anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video nonetheless, and you stick around for more. Briare Oskarensky, over and out.